Hello, this is Rishi21007. This is a video about the awesome Razer. And let's try to make it more awesome. How are we gonna do that? Simple. We'll install one more ROM that is based on the AOKP source. This is solely made by the XDA recognized contributor, that is, I think I'll be messing up my name, Sudru Petro. So I'm sorry sir if I messed your name up, but thank you so much for the awesome ROM. Let's begin. Now, to begin installing the ROM, as usual, you'll need safestrap. So just go in the safestrap, install the recovery. I've already done that, so I'm not going in again. So let's get power off the device. If you don't know what safestrap is and you want to know more, just head over to my channel and see my next video on the safestrap guide. So just power on your device after that. After you have powered on the device, just hit the menu button when you see the safestrap splash screen. So this is the splash screen, just hit the menu key. Now this is a build that is made up from the AOKP source MR1 build 6. Not that it relates much to you, but just to make this video more informative. So this is the safestrap applications menu. Go into the boot options, go to ROM slot 1 and create a ROM slot. For the purpose of this video and to make it a bit short, I'll just select 1 GB. Yeah, and create a ROM slot. Okay, there we go. Now we have made the ROM slot 1. Let's hit back. Go to installs. Now I have kept my downloaded files in the memory card as usual, and I'll be linking up in them to the descriptions. So head over to the descriptions, download the file, keep it in your SD card. Just do that and follow me back. Just going back to my memory card, in my roots and ROM folders, AOKP, AOKP and Sudru Petro. And I'll be selecting this file, that is the release 8. So just select it, confirm the flash. Now the key features that is in the release number 8, I would like to read it out to you. That is the undervolting and underclocking facility, and you can underclock it to 150 MHz. That's really great guys, and thanks to Gitrail for doing that. This also custom voltage mode, GPU frequency can be maxed out to 384 MHz, that is really good. There were some boot issues that have been fixed. There are more governors and more schedulers. Now this is a bit different topic to be talking it right now, so we'll be talking it in the next video or sometime later. Now this is finished installing, so let's go back, and now we have to select and install the gapps. So I'll just go into my gapps folder and select this 2013-03014, that is specifically for Android 4.2.2. Just flash it. Now to avoid any force closes and to avoid any issues during the working and during the flashing of the ROM, please select and make a new ROM slot guys, and be specific to what the author mentions. For example, the AOKP that is built by Mr. Sudru Petro, he clearly mentions that it will work on only ROM slot 1, so please keep it on ROM slot 1 only. After you've done that, after you're done installing the ROM and the gapps, go to the wipe the cache. I usually do it twice, so after that wipe the dilute cache again twice. Just go back and reboot the device. only known issue in this ROM till date is the HDMI connection. It won't work or there are some bugs in it. So I myself don't use it much, so let's see. So that is a very cool animation, guys. You should seriously look at it and just give them your comments. You can comment on the video if you like this animation. Give it a thumbs up. You can head over to the XDA forum and thank Mr. Sudhir Petru for making this awesome ROM. I'll link the thread link in the descriptions. Please go ahead and do that. I think he has a donation link also if you guys want to donate. After all, he has made a really awesome effort making this AOKP build ROM. So let's see. As usual, the first build takes a lot of time, so don't worry about it. So there it is, guys. It didn't take that much long, but it took quite a while. So let's get started. Language, United States, English of course. So start. So there you go, guys. This is the AOKP ROM that is built by Sudhir Petru. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your efforts. Let's begin. These are the statistics. Do turn them on because you, the people at the Kang project, need these statistics. These are not anything to get scared of, but you can just enable it and press it OK. So there it is. So according to the fluidity and a short review, I'll be just doing it. This is almost as speedy as CyanogenMod 10.1, but let's see. I'll be doing a very brief review about it in my next few videos, so please subscribe to my channel, guys. We'll see you there. Next, I'll just demonstrate a few multitaskings. Yes, it's not that laggy. The awesomest feature about this is you can have this performance control, this ROM control inside the device. Then this is installed a new option. It is the device option. So let's see what that is. Using external storage and internal storage. Now this, what this does is you can expand using this the internal storage for the apps and the media. I'll talk about it in my review, so do subscribe and do look for my review. It will be out soon. Let's go and see the About Phone menu. So this is Android 4.2.2 and the release date that was built on the 9th of April. Sorry, this is the Android version 4.2.2. Give a thumbs up, guys, to the video if you liked it. Do give a note of thanks to Mr. Sudhir Petru that has made efforts. Now the main thing about this ROM that Mr. Petru has done is instead of swiping with two fingers, there are no notifications in it. Even if you swipe with one finger, that will get you to the quick toggles. So that's a cool feature and it works fluently. This is the notification panel and this is the toggles panel. Very quick ROM, and I must say it's fluid. Let's use a wallpaper. Let's see this. As you can see, no lag at all. Thank you. that should be enough of application, guys. You can see it is still fluid, no lag whatsoever. Smooth as hell, guys. And according to the specs, it is mentioning it as Jelly Bean 4.2.2, and it delivers. I can say, you can trust me, guys, this is really smooth ROM. And do look for my reviews. For the time being, subscribe to my channel, like, comment and share my videos to any of them who are new to this area, new to flashing for the Razer, etc, etc. Just like the video, subscribe to my channel and share. Till then, till the next time for the next video, we'll see you right here. Bye bye, guys.